Okay, now I want to briefly talk about the transform panel. I'm not talking about the transform that we've just used to flip it left and right, up and down. I'm talking about the one that's down the bottom right here that looks a little bit technical. Now, maybe you shouldn't play around with this too much when first beginning design, but I'll just briefly touch on it. So you can see here it says W and H, that's width and height. And remember, when I click on this and I sort of try and change the dimensions of it, you can see W and H, and it's giving me the readout there. If I go down, I can see that that is the readout of that shape because it's selected. So I can go ahead and just change these. So I just type in 500, press return, type in 500 in height, press return. And now I know that that is perfectly 500 pixels on each side. So what else can we do down here? Well, remember when I rotated the square, you see this little R gives me the degrees. Basically, if I look down there on R, it gives me the degrees. So I could just make it 0, press return, and it will go back to being the way it was before. So that's your rotation. And then this one, S, remember when I pressed skew before, when I was doing that, it said S. That is also giving me the skewage, I'm going to call it. I can press 0 on that and make it go back to the way it was before. What else can you do? Well, basically, the X and Y axis, I wouldn't suggest playing around with this at all, but basically this tells you where it is on the page. So X being the horizontal axis from sort of left to right, and Y being the vertical axis. So let's just say I wanted this square to touch that left-hand side. I would just go here to X and press 0, because that's the start of the document, and it will go there. So these are the kind of things that you can do. And lastly, I'll just touch on this. Let's imagine we wanted to rotate it. I'll just rotate it, let's say 45 degrees, and I'll press return. Why has it rotated from a corner? Well, I'll just press Command Z to go back. You see this little design here? Basically, this is telling it where I should rotate from or where I should expand from. So if I just click the center, see that's selected now, and now I put in 45 degrees, press return, it rotates it from the center. So I chose the center anchor point. I'll press Command Z to go back. That's the basics of the transform panel. Let's move on.